In this video, let's learn about the histology of the palatine tonsil. The palatine tonsil is a pair of tonsils which are present near the junction of the oral cavity. There are a number of collections of the lymphoid tissue that are referred to as tonsils. The largest of these tonsils are the right and left palatine tonsils. So these are the largest tonsils and they are present in pairs. It is almond in shape. And the common word used for this palatine tonsil is the tonsil. For a video on the anatomy of the palatine tonsil, you can click on the I button and you can also check out my video on the valdeus lymphatic ring in the I box. So now coming back to the palatine tonsils. So each palatine tonsil consists of diffuse lymphoid tissue in which the lymphoid nodules are present. The lymphoid tissue is covered by the stratified squamous epithelium, which is continuous with that of the mouth and the pharynx. So the epithelium of the palatine tonsil is the stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium. So this epithelium. So you can note the stratification of the epithelium, the stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium, which is continuous with that of the mouth and the pharynx. So you can see the bottom layer of the columnar cells, in the middle layer of the differentiated polygonal cells, in the top layer of the stratified squamous cells. The palatine tonsil is nothing but an aggregation of the lymphoid tissue that is covered by the stratified epithelium. So these are the aggregations of the lymphoid tissues and the lymphoid nodules are present in this. So these are the lymphoid nodules or the lymphoid follicles. And the diffuse lymphatic tissue is present all over the tonsil. So you can see this is the diffuse lymphatic tissue. And in this palatine tonsil, the epithelium extends into the substance of the tonsil in form of several tonsillar crypts. So these are the tonsillar crypts. This is one crypt. That is a tonsillar crypt. So the tonsillar crypt is nothing but the epithelium extends deep into the substance of the tonsil and they form the tonsillar crypts. The lumen of the crypt consists of usually some lymphocytes that have traveled into the crypt through the epithelium. And sometimes the bacteria and the desquamated epithelial cells can be present in this crypt. So sometimes the crypt contains the bacteria in the desquamated cells. And you can also note the presence of the mucous acini here. So these are the mucous acini and the skeletal muscles are also present. So these are the skeletal muscles. In the clinical correlation of the tonsil, the tonsillitis is the infection of the palatine tonsil. The palatine tonsils are often infected and it is a common cause of the sore throat. And remember, the frequent infection or the frequent tonsillitis or the inflammation of the tonsils leads to the considerable enlargement of the tonsils and it is especially seen in the children. And sometimes such enlarged tonsils may become a focus to infection and their surgical removal may be necessary. So this is a tonsil and sometimes due to the repeated infections it may become enlarged. And the surgical removal of the tonsil is called as the tonsillectomy. So guys, this is all about the histology of the palatine tonsil. So to revise the topic, the palatine tonsil is the largest of the all tonsils and it is almond in shape. It is present at the junction of the oropharynx. In the common usage of the word tonsil referred to the palatine tonsil, each palatine tonsil consists of a diffuse lymphatic tissue in which the lymphoid follicles or the lymphatic nodules are present. And the palatine tonsil is actually an aggregation of the lymphoid tissue that is covered by the stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium. So you can see the epithelium. It is the stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium. You can see the stratification of the layer. And at some places, the epithelium dips into the tonsil to form the deep crypts. So this is a crypt or the tonsillar crypt which sometimes consists of the bacteria and the desquamated or the dead cells. And you can see the presence of the diffuse lymphoid tissue all over the palatine tonsil. And you can note the presence of the mucus acini. So these are the mucus acini here. And you can also note the skeletal muscles. So these are the small skeletal muscles present in the palatine tonsil. And coming to the clinical correlation, the tonsillitis. The tonsillitis is the inflammation or the infection of the palatine tonsil. The palatine tonsils are often infected and it is the most common cause of the sore throat. The frequent infections of the tonsil leads to the enlargement of the tonsil that may lead to the surgical removal of the tonsil, which is called as the tonsillectomy. So the tonsillectomy is the surgical removal of the tonsil, and the enlargement is due to the repeated infections of the tonsil that is especially seen in the children. So guys, this is all about the palatine tonsil. If you like this video, do subscribe to my channel. And do look at some of my recent videos and playlists.